So this is an amazing day in the Marble Machine X project because Carlos Montoro from Anjuda Guitars, Guitar Luthier, is here, and today we're gonna start assembling this bass guitar.
Yeah, finally, because we have been looking for this day for a couple of months.
Yeah, you guys have been amazing in preparing all this almost without using any of my time. While I was busy with the vibraphone, you were taking your own decisions and preparing this.
Let's get started.
That's it, Carlos. Let's go.
So welcome to this first introductionary video about the Marble Machine X custom bass guitar. This project has been long in the making and has been driven by Carlos and Phil. Professor Phil has done an amazing design job with these marble guiding fins, and we will look at them closer in an upcoming episode. This video will be more a kind of overview introduction to the whole bass guitar, and especially we get to meet Carlos, my new friend, the luthier from Anjuda Guitars. One of the most important design changes we're making on this new bass compared to the first machine is that we're using four pickups, one pickup per string, which means we will have four audio signals going out from the bass guitar, which allows us to use individual noise gates per string. This is an amazing thing.
I'm Carlos Montoro, the luthier in Anjuda Guitars. A luthier builds musical instruments in the string family. In my case, I am specialized in repaired and built electric guitar and basses. There was a video in the Whittaker & West Days where Martin was asking for help for several tasks. One of them was the ondophone. And in my career, I tried to go beyond the usual framework of guitar building when I have a chance. So for me, that ondophone thing was like a candy for a kid. So I applied, and eventually I became part of the A-team developing the ondophone. Months later, there was a time where Martin asked me to design and build the bass for the machine. We started buying a bass from the market. I, of course, offered myself to build something from scratch, but Martin felt more comfortable using something that he could see right away and then make the modifications needed. And I choose the 5-string Sterling bass because of its simplicity. Then I focus on the luthier part. The key in this bass are the points where the marbles hits the strings. We're talking about a sphere bouncing in a round shape that is probably vibrating from a previous bounce, and that marbles have to go right into the funnel every time. So everything was built having that always in mind. That involved to measure and to make a new nut with the string spacing that we needed, and to design a new bridge for the bass. Then I designed the layout for the electronics and the pickguard. The pickups are placed 90 degrees from its regular position because the marble hits so hard to the string that all the strings vibrate, not only the one hitted. So having one mic per string, you can control that problem with a noise gate in the mixer. Then the rest was the electronics layout. Find the place for the cable connectors and the four volume pots, one per string. Check this out. Now this guide wall is in the correct 2.5 degrees position.
We're gonna start with an unboxing
because
this package, it says made with California love. This is from Tim Keller and he has machined a very special part we're gonna open right now. Nice packaging.
Come on, check this out.
The reason we're using a 5-string bass is because we want a wider neck because we want more separation between the strings because of the marbles. This was the original one, right, Carlos? Mm-hmm. This is for four strings, so you can see that the distance between the strings makes the marbles be very close to each other. And to guide the marbles, we have these guiding walls designed by Phil. And with the guiding wall next to these strings, we don't have any space. So Carlos designed a 3D printed bridge with more space between the strings. So basically we're drawn out the strings. And now Tim has made the real deal of in stainless steel.
This will last forever.
Basically, when you see me putting this on, we get much more space between the strings, and I can actually have these fences like that, and we still have a place for a marble to fall through and hit the string. So before we can put everything together, we have to check how this is going to sit on the machine itself.
I think we have a problem.
It's a big horn there.
Yeah. You have a saw?
Are you serious?
Yes.
We're just gonna do it like that?
Yeah, why not? Die! Wilson. Hey Wilson, how are you?
Yeah, oh, you didn't meet Wilson before?
No, yeah.
He wants to watch. He's never seen anything more outrageous before. Well,
do you wanna try?
No, no blood on my hands.
15 hours of driving to do this.
This is some expert luthierhood right here. Right,
yeah,
here.
Yeah.
If we just play with the idea to cut out here, mm-hmm, and have it on the same height as the drum. You know, that looks worse actually. It looks better when it's in between here. It looks like we're really planned. So, question to you. Do you think we can slim the body? Mm-hmm. Since the cymbals, there were some nice circles under here, and that this actually should be still a round shape here.
More round. Yeah. So, in this machine, maybe this space of nothing functional,
yeah,
is maybe too expensive to have.
I'm so happy that that we have no sentimental feelings for the body on the bass.
not at all.
Maybe even a little more round. Yeah, that's nice.
Okay, let's start assemble the bass.
Yeah!
This saddle is a little bit different because you can move the string right and left.
This looks very professional. Custom made bridge. We are about to do a microphone test for the bass guitar for the Marble Machine X. We have actually three different kinds of microphones, and we're gonna put all three different kinds on at the same time and use the same string thickness all over the bass, so we can really A-B test these microphone types.
We have three types of pickups. This one is single coil, these ones are humbucker.
So in this one we have a round rod magnet, and in this we have a block magnet, but they also have different materials, mm-hmm, in them. And this is from Lundgren, it's a Swedish pickup, and this is from your friend?
B&B.
B&B pickups from Spain?
Yeah, in Valencia.
Now we're going to mount Phil's amazing print, the base for the fins. He has not drilled the holes, he dremeled them. Okay, let's go, Lundgren. Now we have the BB block with flat wound. B&B rod magnet. Yeah, it's a soundtrack of my life. Okay, we're gonna listen to the recordings in the computer.
Let's listen to the Lundgren single coil. Let's listen to the B&B block humbucker with flat wound string. B&B rod magnet humbucker. B&B block magnet normal string. And finally, a quick side-by-side.
And we have no problem with noise on any of these microphones.
It was my first concern, and I'm very happy that there's no noise at all in all the tracks.
So then we're gonna order 4 microphones from B&B.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Because we are using now prototypes.
Yeah.
Of the design he made.
It works!
Let me say, Martin, that this t-shirt, the cotton of it, feels wonderful.
You're better at plugging my merch than I am. Seriously, I'm not going to embarrass you, but just seeing you work, these simple things, I'm learning so much from you.
Thank you.
And like, if you want to learn stuff, call someone you don't know and try to build something together, because another person is always doing the small things in a little bit different way.
Yeah, exactly. Martin.
Yes?
What have we done with this poor little thing? Look at this.
These are our threaded inserts that we put in for the mounting bracket. And we made these holes oversized, so when we put an oversized washer, we can actually adjust the position of the base, like this. We're gonna use this bracket to attach the base to the Marble Machine X. I'm doing low heat so I can just spread warmth in the whole piece without really melting it. I have a very long arc now, I'm just using the TIG as a torch basically. We're going to do the most scary thing, we're going to tack weld the base in place. Yet now I have more space with the hand, yep. The drum has more space. How's the gear carrying?
Fine.
Fine? So nervous. Okay, this is it. I'm just going to stop the fire in the bass guitar. David 504, our bass is already on fire, okay?
I think.
Whoa! It's so much out of the way. I can't believe it's so much out of the way. I'm so happy, Carlos.
Yeah, me too.
For me to make this decision about where it should go by myself, I would have just been so scared. It really feels like it's for real now.
It feels like it is invited you to be played.
Yes. There it is.
Now you know this is the base of the MMX.
So Carlos made everything else and I added my own touch.
You wanna try?
Try. So doesn't this look so cool? It looks like nothing else. You know that song?
Yeah.
So you can see we need a supporting leg in another direction. It's gonna be better when it's bolted. So Carlos is going to take the electronics of the bass guitar back to Madrid and develop the real pickups with B&B pickups, mm-hmm. The real versions. I'm going to work a little bit with the fins and the marble guides, and we're gonna put it on the machine again. And it has been so fun working with you, Carlos.
Yeah, it has been, yeah.
We just improvised these lines together. That was just a golden moment, just making something together.
Yeah.
improvised, and Tim Keller from Inventopia, who machined this, Phil, who machined the fins. These guys have been working almost without me, and you came here with like a perfect solution.
Thank you.
So you saved so much of my time, and it the result is better than what I could have dreamt of, so thank you so much. So if you need a fantastic luthier and a fantastic person who cares about the relationship between a guitar player and his guitar, you can email Carlos at info@anjudaguitars.com. So we're soon done with the Marble Machine.
Yeah.
I was fan of the Winter Cut on Wednesdays before I jumped in, and having the responsibility of the making of such an important piece of the machine, it's something that is very rare to happen. So I have to give it all for the project. I know this machine will record an album and then will make a world tour and then finally end in a museum somewhere. And knowing that I'm part of all of this makes me feel proud of my work, I'm proud of myself, and I'm thankful to Martin for the present this journey is.
What I love so much about the Marble Machine X project is that I get to meet professionals from so many niche areas. It has been so fun to see a skilled luthier like Carlos customizing the bass guitar for the Marble Machine X. So Carlos, thank you for being part of this project. There's so much more to go into regarding the bass guitar, and we will do that in upcoming videos of Wintergatan Wednesdays. And these videos are brought to you by our backers through YouTube channel memberships or Patreon. Thank you so much to everyone who are supporting, and thank you for believing in this crazy dream that is the Marble Machine X. The Marble Machine is actually a really, really bad idea, looking at it from a first principles perspective, but somehow there's like deep meaning in this process as well. It's like chasing this elusive dream is like a fantastic thing in itself. So thank you to everyone for being part of this journey, and thank you so much for watching. See you on the next one.